Good morning friends. In this video I am going to tell how to create a website using WordPress. So what is WordPress? It is a content management system which used to store all data such as text, photo, music and documents. We are able to edit, publish, modifying the contents of the website. WordPress was initially released on the year 27th May 2003 by Mike Little and Mort Mullenweg. The WordPress was announced as open source in the year October 2009. What are all the major features in WordPress? It is user management system. We can able the user can able to create, delete and also change some account settings by changing the passwords and also user information. It is the media management system. You can able to create a new files, folders, visual presentations, medias, and we can upload videos, etc. Theme system. We can able to change this themes as like us or as like us of requirement. There are some style sheets, images, template files also available in the theme system. There are some plugins also available. We can use the plugins also. It is the search engine optimization tool. It is multilingual and it is used for importing data in the forms of post. It imports custom files, commands, post pages and tags. These are all the major features present in WordPress. What are all the advantages in using WordPress? It is an open source platform and it is available for free. The media files can also easily uploaded. We can use that SEO tools. Customization options are available. The customization likes we can add videos and also we can change the themes, colors, menu bars. We can add several pages, blogs and also we can able to manage the menus and blogs. We can able to add widgets, header widget, footer widget, sidebar widget. We can add any widgets. It allows creating different roles for users for websites such as admin, author, editor and contributors. What are all the disadvantages of using WordPress? WordPress is the, we need to keep the updated version. So while updating the new WordPress version, we may lose some data. So we need to back up the copy of the contents which are managed in our website. Modifying and formatting the graphic images and tables are difficult. Okay, basic customizations. What are all the basic customizations options which are available in the WordPress? Just I will give the overview. Afterwards I will give the clear demonstration. First we are going to log in our WordPress website. That is wordpress.com and it offers the default. We are going to choose the default web page. It offers some names. We are going to choose the name with the free software and we are going to create a website. Now our site is almost ready, which is the message displayed on the screen. Afterwards there is a sidebar which contains customizations tools. Well, that contain admin dashboards, that is the customization control panel. We can change title, logo, color, font type, themes, headers. Okay, we can change everything as per our requirement and we can save and publish. Afterwards adding widgets. In our widgets there are sidebar widgets, header widgets, footer widgets, all are available in our WordPress. So we are going to change the widgets based on our requirement. Like we are going to use some contact informations, we all want to include some clocks or images or videos. So just as like that we are going to drag and drop the files and we are going to add the widgets. These are all the basic customization operations available in our WordPress. Next, we are going to add some content in our WordPress. How we are going to add some contents? First, we are going to add some, there are two types of web pages, right? One is page, another one is blog. In blog, we need to update periodically some essays, weeklies, monthlies, or maybe daily basis. Based on, we are going to maintain some dates. So, we are going to categorize by dates and some keywords. And afterwards, web pages. Here, what are the static contents? What are the things which are going to be shown in our website, like images, some list, menus, tables, etc. Okay, we are going to create here blogs part. Whether we are going to choose a title and you are going to type the title as per your wish, and we are going to preview and publish. We are going to categorize the blog by the keywords. Okay, afterwards, we are going to show. What are the contents available in the website on the dashboards? Managing content in WordPress. We are going to change, we are going to manage some web pages, blogs, medias, and some contact pages, commands, everything in the by customization tools. These are all the advanced customization options in our WordPress. Here, the same customization tool, we can edit some add medias, we can add PPTs, videos. If you want to copy the Moodle sites and videos, in sense, we are just going to copy the address of the YouTube videos on the Moodle site and we are going to paste. If you want to add medias like videos, then you can insert medias and we are going to add the medias. Okay, to change themes, we can able to change the themes. Now, I am going to give the demonstration for creating a website. First, we are going to choose, we are going to search WordPress, and we are getting, this is the home page for our WordPress. We are going to choose get started. We are going to start our WordPress site. This is my WordPress site. So first, there will be option like creating a website or blog. We are going to create a website. So start with the website. Afterwards, I am searching like Karkulali. Afterwards, the karkulaliblog.wordpress.com is available free. So I can select this one as my first option. Afterwards, they will show some options like for free, personal, premium, and business. I am going to choose start with free. Okay, congratulations. Your website is almost ready. Okay, this is the page which I have got after I created my website. Now I want to view my website, right? So we are going to click view my website. After that, I will get my website like this. Okay, this is my website. This website contains what are all the menus available. These are all the menus which I have already added. So what I have to do, I am going to do my size. In the my size, I am going to choose from themes, I am going to choose customize. In the customization, I can change my font, color, site identity, colors and backgrounds, header image, menus, widgets, theme option also I can able to change. Site identity, in the sense I can change the site title. Just here you see I have added Karkulali faculty profile. Now I want to rename the Karkulali profile. Okay. And afterwards I am choosing the logo is like this, so I want to save and publish. Now the contents is saved. Now my website will be like this. Okay. Afterwards, if I want to change the colors and backgrounds, they are giving lot of color palettes. I can change as per my need. Afterwards, This is font. So I just going to choose the font. What is the type of the font and the size of the font, which is a regular normal size or anything. As per my need, I can choose header image. I want, this is my header image, right? I want to change the header image to some other thing. If I want to change this to this one, okay. And I want to publish this, like save and publish. I can able to change my, here you see, it is changing the header image, right? Here some menus. I want to create a menu, right? So here there are several menus available in the website, that is particularly about paper publish. Okay, if I want to add a new menu, I can press the item like add a menu, and I want to type the name of the menus like OER creation. Okay, create a menu. Afterwards, what will be this, be primary menu or secondary menu or footer menu. Okay, I can choose it is a primary menu. Okay, now it will be OER creation is going to be at the, okay, I want to add some items. Okay, I want to add what are the items, what are pages. Okay, if I want to add a new page like this, there are several pages already available. If I want to create a new page, you can select the new page. Okay. If I want to create a new block, I can choose like this. Okay. I'm not save and publish. This is just for example, I give the thing. So just I'm going to contents option. I can change the contents, displaying date, category, full post, that like settings also I can able to change. Here widgets. Okay, what is widget? The widget, the footer one. Okay, you want to choose the, I am just here including contact information. So if I want to include some other thing, add a widget, there will be several options like archives, audios, videos, blog stats. There are several cookies, stickers, Twitter's image, Instagram. Okay, we can choose as per our requirement and we can add the widget. Okay, there are several widgets, footers, headers, anything, any widgets based on the themes. Okay, theme also, option also available. If you want to make the theme in landscape mode or classical or some other thing, whatever the requirement, based on the requirement, you can change the theme options also. If you want to integrate everything in a particular page, I want to edit this particular page in the sense, I can use the option like edit also. If I want to edit the particular page, I can press edit and the page will be like this. There will be add button. Here is the add button, right? In the add button, I can add some media files like PPTs, links, words. I can just copy and paste here, and also if I want to add the media files, I can add. Okay. These are, we can add YouTube video links, and also we can add Moodle quizzes, and we can add screencast videos. Everything we can add here. Just like the example, here I am using the Moodle site website, and also I am going to give the username password. Here you see the screencast website, a screencast video lecture, and also here the PPT. Okay, I can add all the things as per my requirement.